This video will briefly demonstrate how to find scholarly or peer-reviewed articles in RVOneSearch. This will search across nearly all of the library's different databases, so the more specific your keywords are, the more likely you are to get relevant results. I will start with a search for the keywords mass incarceration, and I put that phrase in quotes to tell the search to find these words as a phrase instead of each word separately. I know I have to find scholarly articles for the assignment, so I can check off peer-reviewed right from the search box. This will limit my results to articles that are published in peer-reviewed journals. From off-campus, you will have to log in with your G number and password. Now I'm logged in, and I see that I have about 17,000 results, so my search might be a bit broad, but I can begin to skim through the titles to see if any of them sound like they will help me answer my research question or support my thesis. Keep in mind that scholarly articles are often very specific in nature. They are usually research studies that focus on some narrow aspect of a topic. You can see that from some of these titles. Pay attention to the date the article was published. If you're finding that your articles are too old, say more than 5 to 7 years old, you can use the publication date slider on the left side of your results to only show results from a certain time period. As I'm going down the list and I find an article that looks like it might be interesting, I can click the title to get some more information about it and figure out if it's relevant to my research by reading the abstract. The abstract is a summary of the article, so this will give me a good idea of what this article is about to decide if I want to read the whole thing. If I do want to use this article, or at least read it, I need to go to the full text links on the left-hand side. These might appear in a few different ways. So you'll see I have an HTML full text option. I also have the PDF full text. And in some cases, you might see a full text link that actually links out to one of the library's other databases. But basically, you want to look for these words, full text, and that will take you into the entire article. So now I can start to skim through, read, and evaluate this source. On the right-hand side of the screen are some very useful tools, including an option to email this article to myself, and I can send that to any email address that will be useful so that I have my article saved. This little yellow piece of paper icon will give me options to cite the article in a variety of different citation formats, so I just have to select the format I'm using from the list. You'll want to double check these to make sure that they are correctly formatted, but for the most part, it gets you started with what you will need for your works cited. There's also a permalink icon. If you need to grab a link for the article, either to save it for yourself or share with an instructor or another student, be sure to use this permalink. Don't copy and paste the URL from your browser bar. That one is not going to work again after you've done this search. So you'll want to make sure that you use the permalink in order to save a link to a particular article. If you find an article that has the message that the RVCC library does not have the full text of this article, try copying the title of the article and pasting it into a Google search. Sometimes you can find full articles that are freely available online. If you cannot, or you can't find it for free, you can use this link to request the article from Interlibrary Loan, and we will try to get a copy for you from another library. That does take a few days, so you may also want to skim through the rest of your results and see if there is another article that might work just as well. If you have any questions, you can use the Ask Us button on the right side of your screen to chat with a librarian. If we're not logged on, you can search our FAQ or submit your question to us through email, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Please reach out to a librarian if you have any questions or you feel like you're not finding what you need in RVOneSearch or one of the other databases. We're here to help you.